it's about individuals, like how you will be like your own personal or independent after you reach like the age of 18. You need to be like independent, you move like, to a separate house. In Iraq, the scenario is not like a common. Sometimes the people spend their whole life with their mom and dad, so. And they are always taking care of the older people. Like if your mom and dad, they get older, it's like some kind of, how can I say, like paying back to them. Yeah.
Do you feel like you're told enough about Finnish people and their culture when you arrive here, or if you're told enough about Finnish people and their culture when you arrive to Finland, or there's things that
till now not yet. Okay. And I can also take to their answers now, but till now not yet, because you know the opportunities of engaging and like a variety of events with the Finnish is still limited. So we are like still like a mystery for many of the Finnish, and we are also like seeing, or sometimes we are watching some kind of events we cannot understand or behavior we cannot understand, because there's no dialogue or there is no communication between the two parties.
Have they had any contact with Finnish people? Like, have they played football outside with like an actual Finnish person, or like, is there any kind of connection?
For me, I did what I would ask them also. يقول هل صار عندكم يعني العفو يعني سؤال قبله؟ قالوا شنو قالوا؟ قال لي أكو نوع يعني من الحوار أو خلينا نقول كونتاكت بينكم وبين الفنلنديين يعني صار؟ نعم ما اتصلتوا بأي نوع من الفنلنديين مثلا أو صار حوار وياهم؟ يعني شو تعرف في بيت فنلندي يعني؟
ولا شخص فنلندي يعني عشان تقريبا خمسة شهور.
For him he says like he lived with a Finnish guy for 5 months, so he had like this experience.
يعني بالبداية لا بس من اشتغلت بديت يعني زواين
حتى. He says for him from the beginning no, but now when he get like employed in a salon he start to like chatting with the customers or you know communicate with them.
يعني ملتقي يعني ما بنقول بس يعني عن طريق أشخاص الفنلنديين بصورة عامة وبقية الجنسيات ماخذين صورة عن لاجئين بأن كل هالصورة وحدة بأن كلهم اللاجئين مو خوش لاجئين، هاي الفكرة غلط. أكو لاجئ زين وأكو لاجئ وسط وأكو لاجئ سيء. محتراماتي للكل يعني.
He says like most of the Finnish they have like perspective image or like prejudging, like not all of them to be honest, but there's many people that they consider that the all the asylum seeker as the one bad guy. So it's not like that we are also like a different people. We have the good, we have the so and we have the bad. So it's we are like any kind of cultures or any kind of country. So you can find even in the same house you can find, you know, there's different in the family member.
What education and information would be the most useful?
To assess successful. يقول شنو نوع اسمه التعليم أو المهارات اللي تحبون يعني تعتقدون تفيدهم هنا؟ تعلم يعني مثلا إعدادي يعني في تدريب يعني مثلا مهني هذا الموضوع، شنو نوع التدريب اللي أنتم مفكرين فيه يعني؟ يعني خلينا نقول تعليم اي تعليم مهني بالنسبه لي
باللغه
يعني هم تعليم مهني خلينا نقول
لغه وعمل
for him he says like in the employment office he ask for them that he need a vocational training in his profession like cooking if there's like two kind of things for him language and also a vocational training in his specialty and the same for the film.
About the language, you said if you don't have a permit, you cannot go to the school which you are, and at some point you said that you have some kind of help about the salon, the salon language. So how these things are going to
you know, there's, you have some opportunities, like it's a volunteer opportunities. You go for a volunteering in a job, like just to stay for 2 or 3 weeks, like volunteer, you are not like getting paid or something like that. You just volunteer to experience, you know, the culture, the work environment. So sometimes it happens like that and you can't get a language. For the language courses, there are some camps offer language courses, like inside the camp. Or they can, like in Helsinki, especially in Helsinki, not in Vantaa, not in Lisbon, Helsinki, there are some camps they can offer even a language courses, but it's not like for all the camps.
Unless you get this permit,
yeah.
There will be no.
Yeah, you have like official study, you will have official school, and you will get like the courses and the application courses, so you can continue. سألني عن مدرسة اسمه اللي هو شلون التعليم اللي حاطه يعني ما أدري شلون اللي حصلونه وسألني أيضا على ال اسمه العمل شلون حصلوا قلت له أخوها منظمات يعني هي تيجي يكون كنت تطوعين وجدا ما أخذ الفلوس يعني ما عندنا سبب شركة وبعدين على اللغز I just explained to them what that yeah
do the kids get any chance to study while they are in the camp so even go to some kindergarten with other Finnish kids or
He's not married, but for the other guys, their families are still in Iraq, so their wife has kids in Iraq, so they don't experience here this kind of thing.
What ambitions do you have in Finland, aside from your like career ambitions?
يعني مثلا هوايات رياضة فشي يعني شو رسم أي شيء يعني أي شيء.
أنا هوايتي العمل وأطمح
أن أطور نفسي. وغيركم عندكم يعني هواية ثانية خارج العمل؟ يا رياضة يا رياضة طوبك ثاني.
طوبك.
وحضرتك.
يعني بالنسبة لي أحب العمل. تغيير ما احب الروتين يوميا بس احب اسافر يوميا الدولة يعني كنت في العراق يعني اسافر اتسوق من بقيه الدول واجيب لي
he says you know for him a part of like the job he like football and he like the exercises and you know the sports most of the sports he like them for both of them they like you know to experience a different cultures also travel there is like opportunity because they have a lot of you know, rules in Iraq, so they want like experience a different culture. So they like for that, get contact with different people from different cultures also.
Can you ask him, what
as a student? If you are a politician, this is a good question. But it's a shoe with Shalat and Yahan, it's a good idea. Yahan, for him, he says one of the most things that he experienced in language, he says that the vowels in languages, when you finish language, is too difficult in order to pronunciation. And he says that there is a Finnish word that's too
close. Sometimes we feel the pain.
He says the most important now for them is the language because they can also like communicate with the other parts, they can like experience more about themselves and their skills also to understand what the peers are required from them also.
You know, going through the course, like going through the agenda and following the study contents or do you throw it all back and like
all out and start again. But that's in terms of content of quality, this is important. Quality of content, sorry, I'm blubbering. Okay, and then the real story. So if you find a dead end and you're out of time, I'd rather know that you found a dead end than coming and selling to me that, okay, this is a very good solution, and, you know, just take it. Right? Because, I mean, if it's a dead end, we will see it anyway. So, and it's more valuable to know, okay, what's the real finding here? That, okay, is it working or not? And either way is fine for me. As long as we learn something, right? And the reason why this is important is that, as I said, okay, a bit different graphic, but anyway, some of these ideas we may want to take through this process again. But of course, it's an investment to take them through the process. So we need to know, kind of, you know, are they worth it or not? So that's very valuable to know, okay, this is working and this is not, for that reason as well. Okay, and yeah, let's have you ask questions. I know there are still many things that are not clear. Sorry about that, but we still have 15 minutes to try to clarify. I had a question just during the break now. Are we looking only for digital projects because we are a digital consultancy? And the answer would be that, of course, it's easier for us to put concepts through this when they're digital, because then we can involve also our developers, right? And our kind of programming course collaborations. But that should not be the guiding driver. So if you find something that is not digital, but is a real innovation and is making an impact, then just go for it. And maybe we can still put it through here, or we find another way to make it happen.
And one thing that I think that if you have a kind of non-digital innovation, kind of a process improvement, still you should consider that there might be some digital touch points that are really important in that process. So in a way,
there is always something.
So in a way, there will be something digital related.
Okay.
Would you prefer to have something that would be maintained in time and updated?
Sorry?
Would you prefer something that would be updated in time or upgraded, etc.? Or like a one-time project?
It depends. I mean, of course, we try to avoid maintenance costs. Mm. So we are trying to have the impact and then get the hell out of there. Releases our people for new work. So we don't prefer to have maintenance. How about the theme? Like, okay.
I guess the concept and the feasibility of the concept is most important, plus the efficiency you spoke about.
I would say most important is that is it realistic? So can it really make an impact? And will it work? For us at least. And for following your kind of process as a designer, for me it's important to see that you have really, you know, been honest with yourselves and also kind of try to improve and iterate your ideas. Percentage 5 to 10%, maybe 10%. Well, I mean, it depends what you mean by toilets, because we have other offices. But I suppose you mean
no, right here.
Maybe under 10%. I'm not sure.
Is the
sorry, one thing. So, depending on your ambition level, you can go for something more kind of, you know, bigger and more kind of groundbreaking, or something smaller and more kind of concrete. And they're both very, very valuable. Sometimes the concrete is even more valuable than the groundbreaking. And I forgot to show you this or to remind you of this. So what we have, if you're lost, you don't know where to start, you can still start from here, right? So we have this content, we have 900 something Finnish words and phrases, all with audio files of how they're pronunciated, all with translations into these languages, right? We have put them into Memrise as study courses, but they are kind of free content. You can take the content from us and use it in any way you want, right? So that's something tangible that you can start using already to experiment with it. And you have also the language courses from Memrise. You could do experiments around just going to some immigrants and saying, did you know about this? I don't know. Sorry, yeah, you just did that. Yeah, so you have this as a starting point. And these have, it's really hard to tell because their metrics are a bit broken. So I think that we have 2,000 something learners like spread around these courses, and more than 4 hours average learning duration. So they are used, like there are people using them, right, and benefiting from them. But there are some things that we haven't done. One is that the Arabic course is still like only 300 words and phrases. This can be good or bad, but we haven't updated it with new words. We haven't really made this available anywhere else than Memrise. We have done quite poor marketing. So we just distributed through our own networks, including Red Cross, including startup refugees, in the hope that it will get there. But we haven't gone there and say that, hey, this is in English, but you could still use it. You could get, you know, to the course in your own language. But the platform is in English, so that's all really.
But still, I can recommend that in Play Market.
Sorry?
Yeah,
but I mean, it's in English, right?
Even I have this app,
it's a very popular platform.
Yeah.
And of course, the platform is not ours. I hope everyone knows that. Yeah, we haven't gone beyond Memrise, and we haven't really followed an innovation process. So we just created the content and made it available, and that's what we did. And that's where you can now do much better.
One question that students are supposed to create some solutions to show you. What kind of contents help you to understand the solution, what they have meant? Like, is it the prototypes or user stories, or what kind of output would you need to understand? The solution.
It depends on the solution, and it depends also on the contents of the course and the process. I would expect at least a presentation. So whether it's like this slide sets, or people coming and just talking, or people being actors and showcasing what the concept is like, that's very powerful. And then in addition to that, if you have a prototype of some sort, or some sort of, you know, tangible thing, that's of course extra beneficial.
I think that we are aiming to identifying the key user and presenting the kind of the story of the user, how displaying some prototypes or images to most central digital touch points. So if your concept is all about digital application, then of course you will do a wider prototype, but in case there are many touch points, maybe the key functions of stage at this point. So that's basically something that's.
I understand that this is not the part of our course exactly, but can we code our solutions? So we came up with something, can we
yes,
code it?
Yes, you can. But do you have time here?
Yeah.
But go ahead.
So you're not
thing, yeah, so you can code, but just think about it like as a like the value of the prototype when it's coded. You have to put quite a bit of effort into it to have the same value as a you know mock-up. So just consider it, but yeah, sure.
Are there any resources that you can utilize for future arts? Like, can we contact you? Can we use this space or anything like that?
Yes, you can contact me. I have some time booked for the course that was kind of asked from me, but I can offer extra time as well in addition to that.
Yeah, I think it was agreed that you will join the counseling session at the later part of the course, if I remember it correctly. So I think
yeah, I know. I know. I have some two or three things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
but for sure, yes. And if you need kind of if you need this kind of access to the Startup Refugees Network, for example, I can't promise exactly what I could get for you, but you can at least ask, right? And other kinds of contacts.
And would you like just mainly a proven concept, or would you like independent research, or do you need a prototype, or does it sort of depend on what you're doing?
It depends on what you come up with, but it has to be convincing and to make sense.
Yeah.
That's all.
How many times can you ask the same question?
Do you prefer a single point of contact, that each project team has a single point of contact, so we can avoid a hassle? For instance, when teams have a question, so single point of contact is a team member who maintains discussion between you and the project team.
That would probably be better.
Yes. So now the first task is that make a decision that who will be the single point of contact between project team and the company. Okay.
And we will discuss about Sevi has already mentioned kind of that you have to convince. And how to convince is probably that you don't just say, we discussed about this bit earlier, that you don't just say that, well, we think that this is good, but really that you have tested or you have called someone. Sebi said that very, very good concept. If you make very good concept, you already have someone who is interested in. For example, Red Cross said that, hey, we would actually love to provide this to in our network, or city of Helsinki, or some other kind of customer for your concept, who would kind of start, being as a channel to market it or provide it or so on. So I think in that sense that if you have already kind of get that thumb up from an organization that would actually kind of start providing it, I think that is very good validation.
That would be
already.
Very good. Yes.
Yeah, superb. So.
And like, because I'm a designer, I have heard this, and I have been like working also as a student myself and with students. So I have heard this. We believe many times. So of course it's good if you believe, but I'm not convinced just by that. But if you prove to me that the solution was a bad one, that's very valuable to me. I don't know if it is for the course, but for
I think that's better that you have validated that this was not a good solution, that than you just state that we believe this is perfect, because comments outside.
Was there a question?
Yeah, you answered before. If we have contact with the refugee network.
Someone
curable data. Mm-hmm. What type of curable data survey type do you guys think we use for design your application? First person
what kind of methods we use. Yeah, quite often we do this personal one-to-one interviews. That's our favorite method because it can give quite deep insight into, you know, one customer, another customer. But you know, whatever is effective. So for instance, you could go on to Facebook groups and join the group, start a conversation, and then see what answers you get. That could be, you know, proof of something. Or it's not just to convince me, it's also to convince yourselves, right? That this makes sense.
As a designer, do you have any other advice? Just more like in methods, or I mean, I'm sure you've already given some, like convince yourself and think about the problem, love the problem.
So love the problem, not the solution. Get out of the building. Empathy, have a lot of empathy for target audience. Be honest with yourself. So I mentioned that already. And you probably know about this already. We do have this lean service creation process and a lot of tools that are available for free. LeanServiceCreation.com, I think, or something. You'll find it if you Google. So if you find some inspiration from there, I mean, I think we take already some inspiration from there in the course. But if you want to use extra inspiration from there, you know, feel free and you can ask me if you have more questions.
For example, we have this one lecture. In future, we will have a lecture about the validation, and there's some of your methods. I will open up, but I'm sure that if you kind of grab the material in service creation, you Google search it and discover also some methods and ways to work by yourself. So.
And also, I mean, we have talked before and we have this kind of fancy process, but we learned that we are perfectly aligned on like methodology and tools and approach, right? It's just slight variations here and there in the tools, but the principles are the same, and you know, go with your teacher's guidance. They know what they're doing.
Yeah, but that's kind of good material in general about service development. So
going back to the subject, you prefer greater focus on refugees or immigrants as a whole? Or some other specific group?
I think that's up to you. So if it's refugees, of course, it has bigger social impact. Mm. So it's more likely for us to take it forward. But you know, if it's for immigrants in general, it helps me. I'm an immigrant, right? It helps a lot of people. So if you want to go for that, just go for that.
And what do you mean by exactly love the problem?
Meaning that kind of first make sure that you find a problem that is really, really good and worth solving. So that, for instance, it's not a problem that it has been addressed many times, or it's not a problem that if you solve it, nothing really happens. So it's like, you know, there's some real pain there and some really kind of benefits if it's addressed, that problem, if it's solved, right? And not the solution, meaning that it's so easy to fall into this trap that, oh, I have an idea. Then you start from the idea, and then you're stuck with that. You don't even think, okay, what am I solving with this idea? Right? Why do I have this idea? Where there could be 10 or 20 or 100 other ideas that solve the same problem that your idea is solving, but maybe in a better way.
Solutions that really have some value. So
this is just some examples we can use to build our offer for app, but we can actually add our own.
Yeah, for sure. Just
so we can offer you something. And what we actually think we you might include it in.
Yeah, or what they might need.
About the material you are producing on the course, I mean, an expectation that if you engage with this Futurice project, and at least I have written the Moodle a return folder also that I will share the material with Futurice, so kind of a returning some PDFs there you acknowledge that they will be shared. So in case some of you have some obstacles with that, you must discuss. However, I think this is a really good opportunity for having this kind of real life cooperation and project with a company that does lots of good things. So this is great. However, what I must ask that also I think students then should be able to put those projects to their portfolios.
Yeah, for sure.
And so that's something that. When you have finished your project, you have something to upload to your own GitHub or online portfolio or whatever you LinkedIn, whatever you do to market your kind of
self.
So
I mean, we hope that the outcomes are shared as open source,
mm-hmm.
but the authors are the authors.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So
are you only looking for Finland specific solutions, say, or just.
No.
Because you're an international company, so they can be solutions across.
Yeah,
Europe
it doesn't have to be Finland
yeah.
specific. But.
What's your focus?
Yeah. So remember at some point to focus, right? This is a general. So focus in geography, focus in problem that you're solving. If you go too wide, there's a big risk that you get lost. But aside from that, yes, you can go anywhere in the world. Okay, so if we don't have more questions, what we're going to do is we're going to do this again. And please be honest, I mean, if you're completely drained and confused now after this, just write that. If you still have questions about Futurice afterwards, so whoever still has, you can stay, but we can release kind of the others because we're a bit over time. So then you can.